don't know me, my name is Derek McCaw. I am the Director of Performing Arts here at Notre Dame. For those of you who do know me, my name is Otis Spunk. No, okay. I didn't think that would work. Okay, anyway, of course, what we're about to see tonight is Eve Ensler's Necessary Targets. Before we begin, there are a few things I need to go over, of course. In the event of an emergency, heaven forbid, we have two exits. Either tunnel there, which the official theater term is vomitory for reasons I still don't quite understand. But under those vomitories, either way, you can exit. There's one out the side there and, of course, back through the lobby. As well, they also lead to restrooms on either side. So if you find it's a lot crowded up here in the lobby, there is one out underneath here, underneath the booth. All right? And, of course, they are unisex, so men for Notre Dame, where we can still go. Okay, so also, if you have your cell phones with you tonight, and of course, it's 2009, we all do, let's please be sure to turn off your cell phone or set it to vibrate if you must have it on, like if you're a doctor or something like that. Please no texting. Please, Ms. Orr, no watching videos of other shows while this one's going on. And thank you, appreciate that. Also, of course, we have concessions here. City Lights is one theater in the area that does allow you to eat and drink in the seat. So at intermission, if you want to get concessions, don't worry about, oh, the lights are blinking, I've got to finish up. You can bring it to your seat. All is well there. So, of course, if you enjoy tonight's performance, I encourage you to check out other offerings here at City Lights. Their next show is another Christmas Carol, for Christmas. And after that, we are co-producing with City Lights, Dead Man Walking. And they follow that up with Cyrano de Bergerac, and we follow that up with a Northern California premiere of the musical Earth Sucks, a cosmic rock odyssey. So we're looking forward to that in the spring back across the street at the Julie Billiard Hall. You may also notice some of you are fanning yourselves within these little release forms. We have a couple cameras around. We have a production company filming this for a DVD, and they're going to try to get some audience reaction shots tonight, and so we just ask for a release in case, you know, you're caught picking your nose or something on camera. You say that that's okay, we can use that footage. So, thank you very much for coming tonight. I hope you enjoy, please, Eve Ensler's Necessary Targets.
Traumatized populations.
Doesn't it frighten you?
Yes, Definitely. But it scares me more not to see it. Not to know what's going on. Why are you going to Bosnia?
I'm going for the President's Commission. I was asked, and it's a huge honor. To be honest, I was a bit surprised. I mean, Bosnia is not a place I know very much about. I read the news, but until about a week ago, the Balkans were not exactly next on my vacation map.
And why does this commission want you to be there?
Well, they chose a range of professions for the team. I'm the shrink piece, as you say. At one time, it was my field, trauma.
Yes, eating disorders. I am familiar with your work.
Yes?
You have never been to a war-torn country.
God, no. That's why I want you there, Melissa. Your experience.
War is not exactly the same as anorexia.
I'm a psychiatrist. 26 years. In private practice. I've been involved in a war of sorts. Mental skirmishes and attacks. Trauma is trauma.
In Haiti, the psychiatrists were fleeing like flies.
Haiti?
Yes.
How long were you there?
8 months.
Weren't you afraid?
No, not in Haiti. In Rwanda, yes.
Rwanda?
Yes.
I can't imagine.
No, no one could imagine.
Are you sure you're ready to go to Bosnia to do this again?
It's my work. It's what I do.
You are very strong. So young and so strong.
Is this commission the real deal, or is it one of those UN situations? Observe, witness, but do not go near.
They said we would be working directly with the women war refugees. It's very hands-off. That's why I need an assistant.
Is that what you were told?
What?
That I was an assistant, that I'd be your assistant.
Well, yes, you were to assist me. You were a war specialist and you were to assist me.
I am currently writing a book, investigating the effect of war on the creation and development of trauma, focusing primarily on communities of women and those atrocities that traumatize them. It's my first contract with a major publisher. It's actually your publisher. But it's essential that I complete the book within 1 year, so I will be needing to interview these women.
That shouldn't be a problem. Don't you want something to eat, Melissa? There's some lovely chicken pesto wraps.
It's hard to eat on an interview. The shooting, the crap. Besides, I don't eat meat.
Oh, you're a vegetarian.
Yes.
That must be difficult when you travel. Isn't it hard to find something to eat?
I eat okay. I eat.
Is there something else I can get you? Fruit? Nuts?
No, I'm fine.
What does one wear?
Wear?
In a war-torn country.
You'll need a flak jacket, bulletproof vest, and mud-stomping boots.
Really?
Yes, and a helmet.
Really?
No, we're not going as soldiers.
What are we going as?
Well,